Let's look at the four types of carbocation rearrangements that we talked about. So several different features of the alkene are going to govern which one is relevant for which reaction. So what I've shown is the first step, the acid addition, where we form the carbocation on the more substituted carbon in each case, and now we prep for our rearrangement. So we look next door and we see a tertiary carbon with three R groups, and this is going to indicate an H shift, a hydride shift for us. And so if we look at our available hydrogen, we can shift this. I always use a loopy arrow, but you can use a straight arrow, it's fine. I just use that to show there's a rearrangement. And we shift that next door to form a more stable carbocation. So the driving force is the formation of a more stable cation in the tertiary position. So we then go from a secondary cation to a tertiary cation with a hydride shift. Next scenario is we have a quaternary carbon next door and a methyl available. Let's keep same color there. So quaternary carbon and a methyl is available. And so we can get a methyl shift. And either methyl works for this example. I shift that methyl to form a tertiary cation again from a less stable secondary carbocation. Again, there's a driving force of stability there, more stable cation. What are our differences? Quaternary carbon next door and a methyl available as opposed to a tertiary carbon next door with a hydrogen available. Okay, well, what about if there is a strained ring? So three, four-membered rings are most common. Sometimes five-membered rings will ring expand. And so we look at our carbocation. We have a secondary. And what do? We open the ring and relieve that strain. So the idea is we're not forming a more stable cation, but we are forming a larger ring. So here's where counting the carbons from your original cation are going to be important. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we have to make a four-membered ring with a methyl group coming off on the other side. Now, where is the cation? Well, if you look, carbon 2 loses its bond as part of the ring expansion. And so whenever we remove that bond, it's not making enough bonds. So carbon 2, again, 1 is where the ring closes. 1, keep the same counterclockwise count that we had there. 1, 2, 3, 4. And so that cation is going to go on carbon 2. Still a secondary cation, but it's a four-membered ring now, so less strain. And for our purposes, we are going to say that we're out of time and the nucleophile is going to add at this point. So we don't have to worry about additional rearrangements. But depending on who you ask, if there is enough time, a ring expansion in this case may be followed by a hydride shift to form this cation. So it's not unprecedented to see that occur, but with nucleophiles present, the time it takes to shift the cation, usually a nucleophile has already sniffed out the positive charge by then. So maybe this happens, okay? But primarily the ring expansion is our main concern. One at a time. Let's show one carbocation rearrangement at a time. But reaction conditions can dictate a second shift from time to time. So what is the final condition we can have? We can have more than one pi bond. And if that occurs, and we form a carbocation in the presence of acid, initially, at one of the positions, any one, I just picked one of the two, at this point, we could have a ring closure that behaves just like step one, a Markovnikov-type cation formation. But instead of an acid starting it, it's a carbocation that begins the process. And this is intramolecular reaction. I said intramolecular, between two different functionalities of the same compound. And that's a ring closure. So again, let's count everything, make sure we're not missing anything. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so we end up with a 5-membered ring where we closed the ring at carbon 1. And again, this isn't naming. This is just keeping track of our carbons. And I'm going to number left, just like I did in the left-hand side. If you numbered right, you would keep track of it that way. But I like to start where we close the ring. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Markovnikov would put the cation right here in a normal acid addition, and that's carbon 4 as we've drawn it. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the plus charge ends up here. And so we still have a secondary cation.